Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and everyone in between. I am Dr. John Bear, and welcome back to episode 3 of Barely Surviving. I have been on an adventure. I've got some loot to show you. Look at that. So you can see there, I clearly found a village. I've got some beetroot, some carrots, some potatoes, some books, and some cacti. And I'm going to need that for green dye, which we'll find out later in the episode. Also, I made an AFK farm at the end of last episode, so I've done some things, but this is what we're going to cover this episode. Sounds like a lesson. So I was playing with the AFK farm, so we're going to have a look at what I got with that. I didn't get the perfect fishing rod, only unbreaking 3, low 2, and look at C2. There's definitely better to be done. So we're going to go down, find the red torch in the mines, we're going to build an auto smelter, we're going to go on an adventure, and then I've got some big, big plans, which I'll reveal at the end of the episode. So let's have a see what we've got in here. So empty, 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 and just a little bit. I didn't actually go for too long with the AFK session because I had been Minecrafting all day. My computer was getting a little bit overexcited with itself and the fans were running overtime. So I called it a day. So what I'm going to do is I've got an interview tomorrow. So when I leave the house tomorrow, I will set it AFK. And then when I come back, I don't have to worry about listening to the sound of my computer screaming for its life. So we've got some great books in here as well. Feather Falling 4 and Protection 3, Efficiency 5, 4, sorry. So some good things. And also tons of fish as well, so we are sorted for food. So that's not too bad. So let's combine these two bows together so we've got something a little bit better. Okay, jump cost 10 is not bad, but I think a bow with mending is fabulous. So let's just grab a little bit. We haven't quite got enough string to fully repair that bow. Maybe we'll just leave it in the back in case we absolutely need it. So you see over here, I've done a little bit of work. We've got a bridge there, and I've got a sugarcane farm. Obviously, I've now found a village. We are going to need paper for trading. That's a great way of getting emeralds. And I made this little thing here. You can see this chicken sticking its head out the side there. It's basically an egg farm, and when I'm AFKing up there, I mean the chickens are sat in there laying their eggs. We'll just whiz around and show you. I really need to make a bit more of a feature of it. It's a great way of just getting a ton of eggs. I think I might make a bit of a redstone contraption to automatically fire out the eggs as they're laid, and then we'll have just a chicken slaughter room, which we'll be able to sort out once we have got a decent amount of chickens in that hole. So down into the mines, the second task that we had to do was find the red torch. That is because I also did a bit of mining in between episodes to pick up some resources. Did a good couple of strips, as you can see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I think this is. But as I said, look for the redstone torch. Here it is, and boom, and can you see it just over there in the distance? We have got our first diamonds. Not a very big collection. There's only 4 blocks in there, and I've not even brought an iron pick down with me. Give me 2 seconds, I'll go and get the iron pick, and I'll be back down with you in a sec. Okay, guys, I am back. Got my iron pick, so let's get these broken. I haven't got fortune on this pick, so I'm not expecting any more than 4 diamonds. But that is good. That is us started, and with 4 diamonds, we will be able to build an enchanting table, or we will be able to build ourselves a diamond pick and get some obsidian out of the ground, so that we can have a look possibly into the nether. Obviously we'll need some obsidian for an enchanted table as well, so thinking about it, we're going to need 5 diamonds, but that's not a problem. So next we will get on with the auto smeltinator. Not as good as what we are going to be doing later in the series once we've got a few more resources. This one's just going to be with 2 furnaces and a little bit of hoppers, so we just need to clear a bit of space out. So what we're going to do is it's just going to be 2 furnaces side by side like so. Clear a bit of space out so we can get to both furnaces here. Cool, and then we're going to need some hoppers going into there. So let's just run up and make them. So So, yeah, on the adventure I went on in between episodes, I went south as far as I did. So we went down past this spot, but you'll see later on when we go on the adventure. I found one or two exciting things along the way, but we ended up a good 2,000 blocks away almost from spawn. I've hidden the waypoints, and as you can see, we already had some diamonds. I was just playing with you. But the diamonds that we've just mined, they were the first ones I found, so I left them, kept on mining, but I did find some other diamonds, and I thought, well, we'll mine them out anyway. So we've got a good amount of diamonds. We can make the enchanting table. We can make the diamond pick. But that will be, I think, for next episode, because this is going to be an action-packed episode. I'm genuinely not entirely certain how I'm going to be able to fit everything we've got to do today into half an hour or so. So we've got some chests, bits of iron, so we need to make some hoppers. We need 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, that will do. Cool. And I'm gonna need some more chests, so let's just make a few more of those. Sorted, that should be plenty. And back down into the mine. Actually, while we're up here, let's just pick a bit more coal just to chuck it in the smelting net just to make sure it's working properly. Sorted. And have we got any ores that I chucked up here, or did I smelt them all up last episode, in between episodes? Okay, that's everything. Cool, chuck that in there. Anything else? Did I put them anywhere else? No. Cool. Right. We should probably sort that out at some point. I'll do that on a cut, or maybe in between episodes. But let's jump back down here and love the water drop. I'm a bit concerned knowing what they're going to be introducing for the update aquatic with how water is going to interact with farms, with fences and signs and stuff. Whether that's actually going to work, how we're going to be able to hold back water in the future, or whether we're going to be able to do that. It might just be that we're going to have to drop into water, but it's going to be interesting. There's going to be a lot of mechanics that are going to change. Let's scoot this down a little bit just so that the top chest is on a sensible height to work with. So we need the chest in the bottom there. And then we're going to need furnaces. No, we're going to need hoppers into that chest first. So hopper, hopper, furnace, furnace, and then hoppers, hoppers into the side there for coal, and chests on top for those, and then hopper, a little bit for hoppers. One moment, let's quickly craft some up. Have I got enough iron? Perfect. In fact, I've got just the right amount of chests and iron. Awesome. It's like I knew I had been an idiot. So, hoppers in the top there. And then chest in there, and I think what I might do is just fill in those holes so it's a little bit neater. So just jump up there, come up, yeah, we're all right. Diorite, bop, bop, and bop, perfect. And chest, there we are. So all the stuff go in this chest at the top. Cobblestone will go in there as a good example. We'll just check that's going equally into the furnaces. There we are. And then coal goes in this chest, gets sucked through by both those hoppers and into both the furnaces. Sorted. And then all the outputs come through into the bottom, two at a time, into that chest. Absolutely perfect. We'll just make sure this furnace is working perfectly as well. Excellent. Auto smeltinator. Done. This is going well. Item 3 off the list. Right. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'm going to go back upstairs. I'm going to gather some things ready for our adventure, and I'll be back with you ready when it is time to go. Right, guys, we are back. I have sailed a little bit up from the base. We are just up by the jungle biome, and in between episodes, what I found was a jungle temple, and I also found two desert temples, which we will go and have a look at next. But if we just sail up this little river, absolutely stunning in the middle of a jungle biome, trees overhanging, really nice, something we'll really make a big feature of while we're in the big project, which I will tell you about later. So let's just disembark here and go and have a look what we've got inside. Now, I haven't actually been inside, so I don't know what we're going to find, either here or the desert temples. So we could find some great stuff, we could find some terrible stuff. The only thing I know for certain that we will find in here is a couple of tripwire hooks and some dispensers and some arrows. So let's chuck some torches down so nothing spawns. And I'm not actually very familiar with jungle temples, so I'm not really sure where we need to look for things. So we'll just clear up this upstairs. I know there's all the good stuff, there's some levers and stuff down here, so let's get going. And I'm just treading carefully here to try and spot the tripwire, because I know there is some here, and they will shoot arrows at us. But we'll probably be all right. Where are they? I can see the dispenser in the distance, and it is... Oh, there it is. Oh, and we've got shot by an arrow, so it's there. So, get rid of those. So, string and the tripwire hooks. Perfect. And put a torch in there. And there's another one here. Where's the... I can see them. It is there. So, we'll just break that. Excellent. So, we're safe in this section now. So, we'll just collect those. A couple of arrows in this dispenser. We'll take them. We'll take the dispenser as well. Cool. And what have we got in here? Bit of iron, bit of bones, bit of old flesh. Not particularly exciting, but we will take it. There is, however, we'll just collect some of this redstone from the contraptions. Thank you. And a bit more, not that we're in any burning desire for some redstone. It might be that we come back and take this down just for some of the stone, but it might be that we can actually use this in a bit of a future. So then if you come around the side of a jungle temple, you find some switches, and it should reveal a secret entrance. There you go. Do you hear some pistons going? Where does it go? There's nothing in there. It definitely made a sound. Is it a door up here? I really don't even know what I'm supposed to be looking for. I don't know what changes. I don't know if a door opens or a hole opens in the floor. Yeah, that was definitely a piston. You heard the piston. Yeah. So that there's a piston moving somewhere. Looks the same. That looks the same. Nothing's been revealed. I don't know what I'm looking for. Is it a combination lock? Do I need to get the right one? Ah, because the piston went there as well. So maybe I need to get the right combination. Right. I don't know. You have to let me know down in the comments below how to get in, but I think I'm tempted to just break in, find it. Where could it be? Well, it makes sense that it's behind the switches. If we go and have a look at the redstone behind the switches, we should be able to find it. Where is it? So if we're coming behind here, because the switches are connected to redstone something. Oh yeah, I can see the piston. Oh, there's a chest there. So there's some pistons we're going to have. Let's just see how it works. Ah, so it looks like it might reveal something up there. Anyway, we've got a diamond, 6 iron, and a bit more stuff, and a saddle. We'll just get in here and we'll take the sticky pistons, because they are very useful. And until we have a slime farm built, that is what we need. So you can see, it looks like it reveals a little drop-down hole from up there. So we'll take those, we'll take that, and we'll take the levers with us as well. Not that they're a particularly expensive craft, but we might as well take them. It will save us a job. So that be that. So what I will do is I will head back to the base. I'll drop this stuff off, and then we've gone north up to here. I will be back with you when we are going south down to the desert temples. Right, ladies and gentlemen, we are just beginning to close in on the desert temples. They're pretty close. I'm not sure which one's closest, but we are going to go to this one first. So you've got a bit of a savanna hills there. So we'll run around the side up to them, then we'll jump across to the other desert temple. As I said earlier, I've not been to either of these, so I do not know what we are going to find. It also means that they have not been deactivated. These are two very live desert temples, still primed with dynamite, so there is every possibility we could go a little bit kaboom. So let's hope for not that, because nobody needs a dead bear. In fact, the first time I ever came across one of these, a while ago now, I'm not one for rage quitting, ever, anything. And the first time I discovered a desert temple, you can just see where we've been. We've come directly south, so the jungle temple was there, and we've come all the way south here. The spawn point is about there, so we've come all the way down south. And you can see, here's where we are heading to now. That's the other one, and there's a village there. So that's where we're going. So we're going to go back to this, jump across the savannah and up to the village. But yes, the first time I ever discovered the desert temple. I dug down, wasn't aware of the pressure plate, wasn't aware of the TNT at the bottom. It exploded. It exploded all the loot. It killed me. And I was so, so angry. I logged out. I was on a server with my mates at the time. I logged out, told them to shove Minecraft where in places they probably wouldn't want to. And I vowed never to play it again. And it was actually a cut 2 or 3 days before I'd relented enough to be able to come back to it. But here is the first desert temple. You see, I've already been in here and lit it up, but I've not been down. This was just to stop anything spawning during activities. So we'll go down. I always tend to go down this side one here, which is completely safe. Just revealing this shaft. If you've not been down in one before, make sure you come down the side, because there's a big shaft there. And as you can see, there is some TNT, and you need to take that out first. So we'll just collect all of that. Come here, my precious. And we'll then jump back up here. And then we can take out the pressure plate. If you step on that before you take out the TNT, you are a goner. So we've got a couple of emeralds, a book. So we'll take out these chests. What have we got? A bit of iron, some bones, some string, a bit more creeper poo, a ton of rotten flesh. That's good, especially considering we're on our way to the village. If we can pick up a decent amount of rotten flesh in here. Oh, a couple more books. What have we got? So we've got aqua affinity, good, and look at the C3, that would be good on our fishing rod. So we'll take that, and we'll leave just one chest down here with a bit of junk that we don't really want to take. We don't need gold horse armor. If we're going to have horses, they are not wearing gold armor. They're probably going to wear iron or diamond, hopefully, if we can find some. So that's cool. So we'll leave one chest down here, and where did I come down? Here, right, let's jump up and we'll get heading over to the second one, and I will give you a shout when we are back there. Right, we are back, and we are just coming over to the second desert temple. It is just over this hill, so we'll cross this river. The village is now right over on my right, just directly to the north of us. We've just crossed a little bit below that. So we will do this. Let's get up here. And I have just thought it is probably going to come to night time while we are out and about here. And I haven't got a bed with me. So that'll be interesting, especially considering we're so near a village. I don't want to risk things spawning. If we're going to have to survive the night, risk things spawning. Right, let's jump up here. Nope. Make a little bit of a pathway into here. Cool, yeah, we don't want things spawning to kill all the villagers, because there is a cleric there, and we are going to want the cleric, because we can eventually trade with him for ender pearls, which is a great way of getting ender pearls early game, before you've been to the end. So light this up, and again, we will go down, clear out the TNT, and that is 2 safe jungle desert temples deactivated, which is very nice. So we'll just jump back up here and have a see what loot we get in this one. So first one, 2 emeralds. That is good. So we're up to 4 emeralds before we've even got to the village. Bit of gold, a golden apple, some more rotten flesh. That's nice. And another golden apple, but otherwise nothing particularly exciting in that one. And a bit more TNT and some iron horse armor. That's a bit more like it. That's better than golden horse and armor. So we will get that. Dump again a bit of junk in this one chest, which I like to leave at the bottom. It's quite good fun when you're playing this on a server sometimes to take all the loot. Leave just one chest there full of turdy things. Replace the sandstone, as we are about to do now. It looks like it's undisturbed. And remove all the torches once you've been in here. So someone will come and think, oh yeah, I found a new desert temple. it's not a new desert temple. In fact, another one, another good one would be to replace the TNT and put in some tripwire hooks. So we'll pick up some of this sugarcane as well, but the sun is going down. We haven't got a bed. We're very close to the jungle. And let's just turn off these notification waypoints. And I wonder if we can make a bed. We did cross over the savannah plains. I wonder if there's some sheep that we could take out for some wool. Let's have a thing. Actually, I have got enough string. Do I want to use it to make wool? We are short on string. I've not come across any spider spawners or anything yet. But we are a bit too close to the village, and I would like to get there, not risk things spawning and taking them off, because there is not too far away at all. There are some trees over there, so maybe we could get some wood if we head over there. But if we need to head away from the village anyway, because it's night time, and we don't want any zombies spawning there and killing all our villagers. So let's get over here. And I think what we're going to have to do is we'll take down that tree, we'll turn some of our string into wool, and we'll make a bed that way. Just need to hopefully get this done before anything spawns nearby and kills us. We're just going to need two bits of wood. So crafting bench for one of them, chuck that down, and quickly make some wool, 1, 2, 3, and then a bed. Perfect. And we'll shut that down. Hopefully we'll be able to get this down so we can sleep down. And excellent, nothing spawned yet. So that's good. We're not going to get killed by things in the night. More importantly, hopefully our villagers won't get killed. Let's just take down the rest of the tree, head to the village, and we'll see if they've got anything good for us. Just clear this. I don't think actually we've got any acacia wood back at the base, so that is good. We are up to 5 trees now, 5 of the 6 trees, so that's good. We only need to find a dark oak forest, and we'll have all of them. Let's just take a poppy. I don't like the white beds so much, so we'll just dye that one. I like to have them all different colours. I'm going to have a full array of different coloured beds as I go along, but back to a red bed this time. And I say I always forget to take them with me until I get shulker boxes and I'm carrying an ender chest around with me everywhere. I always forget to bring beds and like a adventure away kit. But I tell you what, my phone is ringing, and this is the next day. I've had an interview, so I'm going to be back with you at the village in a second. Right, I am back, and I'm a little bit closer to the village. It wasn't a job offer, unfortunately. It was somebody else ringing me about a job. Not very exciting, because I thought I'd already applied for them. By the by, back to Minecraft. So let's make a waypoint for this village. Let's call it Village. This is going to get tricky if I find another village. It may be just village 2. I'll be very, very innovative. And we need a cleric. He's not a cleric. But let's trade with him anyway. I need the cleric. Why are you in the church and without a cleric? You just wait for me. Here we are. You've got parishioners in there, and they're just out here wandering around. 40. 40 rotten flesh is a very expensive cleric. But, right. That is our first trade. What a deal. So we've got an emerald. Unfortunately, clerics are then notoriously bad to level up again. Then it is 1 emerald for 3 pieces of redstone or 2 pieces of lapis. Absolutely atrocious. I've never seen a good trade for that. But let's trade one of those emeralds for that. There you go. He's got his particle effect, so he's leveling up again. And now, when we go into trade with him, you will see only 7 diamonds for an enderpearl. You also get a glowstone, but enderpearls are where it is at. So you see why I've started farming the sugarcane. It means that we can get a ton of books, bits of paper to trade with a cartographer or librarian. I can't remember which one it is. One of the ones in the white coats. But let's just get him in, because in a survival world I was just playing, I had a cartographer. I traded with a cleric. I traded with him up to and including this point. Went back and then came back and it just completely disappeared. It wandered off, gone on, followed Jesus on a disappearing act into the middle of the desert and never came back. It was a nightmare, but he is there and will be there for us to trade with forever. Who are you? Weaponsmith. That's not a bad price for coal. Sometimes you can get some decent enchanted weapons from him, so maybe we'll trade with him later. I've already got the goodies from the blacksmiths in the village. Just taking out the books. Let's see if we can find a white coat. Let's have AC. Here we are. Here's one. A cartographer. It's a cartographer that wants paper, and I picked up a little bit of sugarcane. So let's see how much paper that gets. 27 out of how many does he want? 29. Ah, so close. Well, we're in the desert. There's got to be some more sugarcane just on the coast here. There we are. So let's run up and get this. And I believe, although I've never actually done this one, that if you trade with a cartographer a few levels up, they will give you a map to a roofed forest. And I believe it's roofed forests where woodland mansions spawn. And I've never, ever, ever been to a woodland mansion. So maybe what we're going to do this series is at some point we'll trade up with him. Not for now. We'll do that and we'll possibly go to the end first before we take on evokers and that sort of thing. I've seen videos. I know how bad it can be. But we'll just plant surplus sugarcane there so we've got that growing while we are nearby resources. I only need one more bit of crafting for the paper. So let's check that out and come back. Trade with him for some emeralds and let's see what else he is going to offer us. In fact, maybe we want to trap him in as well. So let's just craft a few more of those. A compass of an emerald. That's definitely not worth it at the moment. That's a lot of resources to get one emerald. Who are you? Butcher. Never trade with them in my life. And a fisherman. That's a good price. Let's offload some of this string for another emerald. And he's probably going to offer some good fishing rods, but our AFK fish farm is going to get some good fishing rods anyway. Let's see what he has to offer. Cooked fish, no. Lure one for 7 emeralds. No, not today. So, done with that village now. What we will do is we will head back north and I will meet you back at the base. I'll be back in a sec. Right guys, we are back. I've been to the base, dumped everything off, but I noticed on our way back that there is the swamp biome where we died in episode 1, a little witch's hut. So let's go and have a see if there is any goodies in here. So let's break this bad boy so we can get up in here. Can't hear any witches. So we'll take that flower pot. Anything in the cauldron? No, we'll take that. No brood stand, which is a shame. So we'll take that down, see if there's any witches nearby. I can't hear any witches. So that's everything that we were going to do this episode, and now it is time for the big reveal. And I am looking down because you will be able to see it from here. Let's just sail out a little bit more so you get a better view of it. You might be able to start telling now, but there. Yes, you are right. Jurassic Park. We are going to spend an absurd amount of time, I think, this series in the jungle biome. It just feels right. That's the idea I had a couple of episodes ago. This is the main entrance to it, and I love to build, you know, just clear out some big bits of the jungle, make a good track all the way around. You know, we're going to spend some time building some giant dinosaur statues, and you know, we'll have it as a thing. But if you look at it, this jungle biome is absolutely huge. You know, we've already been up some of the rivers. It's going to make some, you know, just a really good interactive, like Jurassic Park Visitor Center. When I put the seed into mineatlas.com, it shows you how big this was. Let's just have a quick sleep here. But yeah, I think this is going to be so, so exciting. This is what I'm really, really excited. I've been trying to hide it. But, ladies and gentlemen, that is it for this episode, I think. So if you've liked it, please hit the like button. If you haven't already and would like to, please hit the subscribe button. Recommend it to your friends, all that jazz. And, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for watching. And I will catch you next time.